we present a perceptive locomotion controller for quadrupedal robots that combines fast locomotion and exceptional robustness on challenging terrain. The controller successfully traversed a variety of challenging natural and urban environments over multiple seasons with the same locomotion policy used for all deployments. It conquered loose terrain, stairs in obstructing fog, difficult hiking paths, and many more, which pose great challenges for perception and locomotion without a single failure. We conducted a hiking experiment on the Etzel Mountain in Switzerland to test if the robot could complete an hour-long hike up and down the mountain. The hiking loop was 2.2 kilometers long with an elevation gain of 120 meters. The official signage suggests 35 minutes to reach the summit. Completing the trail required traversing steep inclinations, high steps, rocky surfaces, slippery ground, and tree roots. Despite all the challenges, the robot reached the summit in 31 minutes, which is faster than the expected human hiking time. On the descent through a forest, tree roots formed intricate obstacles, the ground was slippery, and vegetation above the robot sometimes introduced severe artifacts into the estimated elevation map. Despite all the challenges, the robot finished the hike without any human help and without a single fall. It completed the hike in virtually the same time as suggested by a hiking planner. This also enabled autonomous operation in the DARPA Subterranean Challenge, where Team Cerberus deployed our locomotion controller autonomously over extended periods of time in underground environments with rough terrain and degraded sensing. Our locomotion controller explored the underground environments over 1.7 kilometers without a single fall, helping Team Cerberus win the first prize. Our controller was also used in South Africa, traversing natural environments. It enabled research on the interaction between robots and animals. Here is how it works. The robot builds a local height map and samples the relative terrain height around each foot. The locomotion controller utilizes this information to anticipate upcoming terrain and perform smooth locomotion over obstacles. However, this map information frequently becomes unreliable in the real world. To remain robust under such conditions, the controller has to learn to ignore misleading exteroception and rely on proprioception instead. We introduce an attention-based recurrent encoder that combines proprioception and exteroception into an integrated belief state. We employ an attention mechanism that allows direct access to exteroception when it is reliable, but learns to discount it when exteroception is degraded. We employ a privileged training procedure. We first train a teacher policy on a variety of terrain using reinforcement learning. The teacher policy has privileged access to all ground truth information from the simulator and learns an optimal reference motion. We then train a student policy to imitate the teacher policy, given observations of varying reliability. The student contains the belief encoder and also tries to reconstruct the ground truth height samples to encourage an informative belief state. This is illustrated in this controlled experiment, where the robot walks over a soft foam block, which appears solid but cannot support a foothold. When the robot tries to step on the compliant surface, the sinking foot contradicts the anticipated terrain profile, and the policy immediately revises its internal belief about the terrain. This estimate remains intact as the robot continues stepping due to the recurrent structure of the encoder. This also enables stepping over the transparent obstacle. Even while the sensor is covered, it can utilize the proprioceptive information. Once it hits the step, it can recognize and walk over a stair. The belief encoder can also estimate friction, making it robust against slippery surfaces. And it can also estimate external disturbances, making it robust against them. This automatic and adaptive integration of exteroception and proprioception makes our policy robust to exteroception failures frequently encountered in the wild. On loose ground, feet sink into the soil, which causes drift of the kinematic pose estimator used to construct the height map. The robot proceeds regardless, and locomotion remains smooth and fast. In deep snow, height information has a large height bias or is completely missing, After stepping onto the snow and sinking into it, the robot identifies the true ground height and ignores the misleading exteroceptive input. When perception is reliable, our locomotion controller leverages it for fast and smooth locomotion. Stairs, which typically require a dedicated locomotion mode and strictly forward walking with other quadrupedal locomotion solutions, can be traversed swiftly in any direction by our controller without any manual mode switching. This work presents a robust and general solution to integrating exteroceptive and proprioceptive perception for legged locomotion. We achieve the best of both worlds. Fast predictive locomotion with exteroception is informative, and extreme robustness even when it's not. This is a significant step on the journey of legged robots out of the lab and into the wild.